Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, ACCUPLACER Review, Elementary Algebra, Problem 50. This is the Elementary Algebra ACCUPLACER Review, Problem 50. We have 4x minus 3y in parentheses, and the parentheses are raised to the second power, or squared. So what that means is we're going to have that set of parentheses times itself. So we'll have 4x minus 3y in parentheses times 4x minus 3y in parentheses again. And we have to multiply that out and combine whatever we can. So 4x times 4x will be 16x squared. Again, the 4 times 4 makes the 16, x times x, x squared. Next, 4x times minus 3y. So the 4 times the minus 3 will be negative 12. X times y is xy. Again, it could be written yx, but it's traditional to write them in alphabetical order when you have more than one variable. Xy and yx are the same. I put them alphabetically. And now, negative 3y times 4x. So again, negative 3 times 4, do the numbers first, is negative 12. And then y times x would be yx, or again, xy is the same alphabetically as most traditional. And then finally, negative 3y times negative 3y. Pay attention to your signs. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. And then y times y would be y squared, or y to the second. Now, the 2 minus 12xy's in the middle can be combined. The 16x squared, there are no other x squares to combine with, so 16x squared is done in terms of what's going in the answer for x squares. But the xy's show up in two places, negative 12 and negative 12 again, so I have negative 24xy. And then the 9y squared, there are no other y squares in my answer, so I'll just pull a 9y squared into my answer. And now, if you look at my answer, 16x squared minus 24xy plus 9y squared is a perfect match for option D. So the answer to problem 50 is option D.